So for that report writing, I require two students from Mahadevi Verma house and two students from Kalidas house. So today till evening, you make up your mind to take this decision and you just tell me. Two students from Mahadevi and two students from Kalidas house. I require otherwise students from Shakespeare house and Bhai Veer Singh house. This selection has been done. Okay, now without wasting much time, let's move to the content that what we are going to do today. We are going to read a very, very beautiful chapter that is My Childhood. My Childhood, that is a very good chapter. It is telling about autobiography of APJ Abdul Kalam. See, APJ Abdul Kalam, he is a role model for all of us. Okay, he is a true inspiration for all of us. And there is a very famous book that is Wings of Fire. Wings of Fire is a very, very nice book, very famous book that is written by APJ Abdul Kalam. And this chapter in the form of the extract has been taken from that book, Wings of Fire. You jot down the name of this book in on your book so that you can learn it. Wings of Fire. This book is written by APJ Abdul Kalam. And this extract is taken from this book, Wings of Fire. Okay, you should know about this thing because it is a very famous book. And whenever you get a chance, whenever you get time, you should take this book from library. You should go through this book and you will come to know in detail about life of APJ Abdul Kalam, that which kind of hardships did he face? How did he rise like a star? How did he become famous? What kind of hurdles and problems he faced in his life. So this all we are going to read about this great personality, APJ Abdul Kalam, in this chapter. In his autobiography, he tells about his childhood. So you are also a child. So when you will come to know about this thing, so you will come to know that how much courageous he was, and he was also having so many hurdles and problems. How did he face them and how did he polish it, and how did he rise like a star? It doesn't mean that he was from the beginning he was having all the things in his life. He had to achieve all the things by facing lots of problem. He was an ordinary child like you, but how did he think about his mission? His vision was very much clear. Who inspired him? Who gave him inspiration? And how did he work on his vision? How did he work on his dreams? And how did he become famous in that? All the things you are going to read about this thing in the form of extract in this chapter, My Childhood. And this is a childhood of APJ Abdul Kalam, who is a great scientist. Okay. So let's read about this. So many adjectives can be added with APJ Abdul Kalam. Now think about all the adjective. I have used only one adjective, that is a scientist, but not only one. There are so many adjectives that we can add with the personality, with the name of APJ Abdul Kalam. Now write down, start typing all those adjectives, all those personality traits that we can add up with APJ Abdul Kalam. What comes right in front of you, right in your mind, just type in chat box. Hurry up. I want my own. Yes. One of the students has written genius. Okay. Other adjectives that you can add with APJ Abdul Kalam? Witty, intelligent, missile man. Very good, Ridhima. He is considered as a missile man. Yes, very much intelligent. APJ Abdul Kalam is considered as a missile man. Energetic, hardworking, having a great vision. Remarkable, inspiration. Yes. So many adjectives are there. Intellectual, work alcoholic, Indian aerospace scientist. Clear. So many. Yes. So let's read about this chapter and we will come to know so many other personality traits of his life, of his character. So I'm so eager to teach you this chapter. I think my lovely student should also be so eager to know about APJ Abdul Kalam. because by reading this chapter you will come to know about his biography, about his life, and especially the days of his childhood, which is taken in this chapter from the book Wings of Fire. So let's begin with this. I'm going to increase the font so that should be visible to you. Okay. Now, Ridhima, you read only first paragraph.
Yes, I was born into a middle-class Tamil family in the island town of Rameshwaram in the erstwhile Madras state. My father, Jainulabidin, had either much formal education nor much wealth. Despite these disadvantages, he possessed great initiate wisdom and a true generosity of spirit. He had an ideal helpmate in my mother, Ahishyama. I don't know, not recall the exact number of people she fed every day, but I am quite certain that far more outsiders ate with us than all the members of our family put together.
Okay, very good. Now, bachche, underline difficult words, write down their meanings. Only then you'll be able to understand the meaning of the chapter. Okay? I'm writing difficult words in front of you. So write down their meanings. Some meanings are given in your books, but some are not given. So it's better that you write down their meanings. And it will be easy for you to understand the meaning of the chapter. So these meanings I have written in front of you. I is used for APJ Abdul Kalam. APJ Abdul Kalam is telling about himself. So here narrator is writing about his autobiography. So I is used for the speaker of the chapter, that is APJ Abdul Kalam, that he was born into a very simple middle class family. It was a Tamil family. And where was that? This family was in the island town of Rameswaram. That is a place. And erstwhile Madras state. Erstwhile means initially, in the beginning. But what place was that? It was Madras. Okay. But now name is changed. Which name is, new name is given to Madras? Tell me. Can any of you tell me? Yes. Chennai. So what was the name of the father of APJ Abdul Kalam? That was Jainulabidin. Okay. See, he was not having so much education. It means his father was not so much well educated and not so much wealthy. It means his father was not so wealthy and rich and not so much educated. These were all the disadvantages. But despite these disadvantages, he possessed great innate. It means his father was not so well educated, nor so rich, but he had a great innate. Innate means he was born with this quality. What was that quality? That he was having a lots of wisdom. He was so much intelligent. And a true generosity of spirit. True generosity of spirit means inbuilt it was there, that inbuilt he was having so much intelligible vision. He was so much intelligent. He had a great wisdom and such kind of spirit that person was having. And because of that, you can say that his father was a true helpmate. Helpmate, the meaning of helpmate is a wife. In my mother, that he got a very good wife, that was his mother Ashyama. What was the name of his mother? Ashyama. So that was his mother. But now here in this line, he is telling, APJ Abdul Kalam is telling, and you will be surprised to know that he did not belong to a very much well-renowned family. He belonged to a very middle-class family, simple Tamil family. Okay, father was not so well-educated. Father was not having so much money, but he was a person of true wisdom. He was so intelligent. Okay, and wife was also good. It means his mother was also good. I do not recall. It means if he wants to recall, if he wants to remember this thing, that how much exact number they were feeding. It means they used to feed, they used to provide food to needy persons. So he was not able to recall, he was not able to remember the exact number of people to whom they were providing food every day. But he was certain, he was very much sure that far from outsiders ate with us than all the members of our own family put together. It means his father was providing food to all the family members also, and some other person from the family member, outsiders who were in great need, who were poor, who were needy, who were, you can say, not able to afford food. So that family was providing food to poor people also. Rather, they belong to a very middle class family. Clear? And you write down the meaning of these difficult words. Now let's move to next paragraph. Who is going to read second paragraph? Okay, Dhiren. Dhiren, what is in front of you? It is virtual mic.
Ma'am, it is a mic, a bigger mic. It is a speaker also.
It is virtual or it is a...
No, ma'am, it's a real mic. It's a real mic.
Okay, read second paragraph.
Okay, ma'am. I was one of the many children, a short boy with rather undistinguished looks, born to tall and handsome parents. We lived in an ancestral house which was built in the middle of the 19th century. I was a fairly large pakka house made up of limestone and brick on the mosque street in the Rameswaram.
It's not mosque, it is
mosque street, yes. In Rameswaram. My austere father used to avoid all the inessential comforts and luxuries. However, all the necessities were provided in the terms of food, medicines, or clothes. In fact, I would say mine was a very secure childhood, both materially and emotionally.
Okay. So I think you all have written the meanings. So what is given in basically in second paragraph? He was having so many brother and sister. Okay. And now in this paragraph, he has told about his look, that he was a short boy, undistinguished look. Undistinguished look means ordinary look, not so good looking, but he was born to a very tall and handsome parents. It means his parents were very much tall and very much handsome. His parents were very much tall and handsome, but he was having a very ordinary looks. Okay. And where they were living in a very ordinary house, ancestral house. Ancestral house means the house that belonged to their forefather. So that house was built in near about in 19th century. And this house was fairly a very pakka house. It was made of limestone and brick, and it was on the Mosque Street. Mosque Street means the name of the street is given. And this is a mosque period because in this period there was one of the mosque. In Hindi we say masjid. It is mosque. Don't speak mosque to the Dhiren. It is mosque. And this mosque was in Rameswaram. Okay. My austere father, austere means now the qualities, traits of father is given in a very beautiful word. Austere, what is the meaning of that? His father was very much simple, but he was strict also and he was fair also. Okay. And his father was like that. He used to avoid all inessential comforts. Inessential means which are not required too much by us. Okay. So his father was like that, that he did not provide, you can say, inessential comforts and luxuries to his children. However, whatever the basic needs, whatever the basic necessities which were required, they were being provided by the father. You can say food, good food is provided. Good, you can say good food was provided. Medicines, clothes, basic needs, books, etc. All the things were provided by father, but not luxurious life, not comforts, etc. So, in fact, I would say mine was a very secure childhood. So here APJ Abdul Kalam, that great personality, is writing about his childhood. And he is saying that he was having a very good childhood, both materially and emotionally. Materially means all the material, all the basic needs he was having, which were fulfilled by his father. And emotionally also means whatever the love, affection which was required by a child from his parents, that was also given to him. Okay, so that was all about childhood of APJ Abdul Kalam. Now, one of the incident is given by APJ Abdul Kalam here in third paragraph. So I want that, Arzu, you should read this. Arzu, you should, third paragraph.
Yes, ma'am. The Second World War broke out in 1939 when I was...
Yes, what happened?
The Second World War broke out in 1939 when I was 8 years old. For reasons I have never been able to understand, a sudden demand for tamarind seeds...
Tamarind. It is not tamarind, it is tamarind.
Tamarind seeds erupted in the market. I used to collect the seeds and sell them to a provision shop on Mosque Street. A day's collection would fetch me the princely sum of the one anna. My brother-in-law, Jalaluddin, would tell me stories about the war, which I would later attempt to trace in the headlines of Dinamani. Our area, being isolated, was completely unaffected by the war. But soon, India was forced to join the Allied forces and something like a state of emergency was declared. The first casualty came in the form of the suspension of the train half at Rameswaram station. The newspaper now had to be bundled and thrown out from the moving train on the Rameswaram road between Rameswaram and Dhanoskodi. That forced my cousin Samusdin, who distributed newspaper in Rameswaram, to look for a helping hand to catch the bundles, and as if naturally. I filled the slot. Samusdin helped me earn my first wages. Half a century later, I can still feel the surge of pride in earning my own money for the first time.
Okay. Now see, very beautiful paragraph it is given. Now there is a twist in this. What is that? What time was going on? It was a time of Second World War. What was that time? In 1939, when Second World War started, and at that time APJ Abdul Kalam's age was only 8 years old. See how young he was. He was basically a child, 8 years old. I think he might be studying in second or third class. Okay. So he was not able to understand what is that Second World War, why it had broken out, because he was a child of only 8 years old. Okay, but there was sudden a demand for tamarind seeds. What are tamarind seeds? Can you tell me the meaning of tamarind? Anybody can tell me that is a very sour object? We really enjoy to eat it. What is that tamarind? Yes, in Hindi we say imli. Its taste is very sour. Okay, so there was a sudden demand for tamarind seeds erupted in the market. Okay, so this demand was in the market, it was increasing. And what was his job at that time? He used to collect the seeds and he used to go in a provision shop. And this provision shop, this grocery shop was situated in Moss Street. Okay. So whatever the collection he used to do for one day, so it would make him able to earn near about one anna. That is a, you can say rupee, one anna, that is the amount. Okay. So there his brother-in-law, Jalaluddin, would tell me stories about the gold. His brother-in-law, Jalaluddin, now afterwards he used to tell him the stories about that war. And which these kind of story he used to find out in the headlines in Dinamani. Okay, there was one area which was being isolated. Isolated means it became separated. This area was completely unaffected because in war all the areas were being affected, but there was one area which was not affected at all. Okay, but soon India was given pressure that they should join that allied forces, and something like a state of emergency was declared. It means such kind of situation was going on in his surrounding when he was only 8 years old. And first casualty came. What was that casualty? That suspension of the train halt at Rameswaram station. So such kind of casualty was called. Okay. So what is that elite forces? Write down the meaning of this. Sorry, it is given in front of you that the armies of UK, USA and Russia during the Second World War. Okay. So for that, this word is used. So India was forced to join that they should join with the armies of UK, USA and Russia during the Second World War. So this kind of pressure India was having at that time, and in this state of emergency was completely declared. Okay, train halt at Rameswaram station. Okay, now what was the duty at that time? That now the newspaper had to be bundled. It means what was the job of that? That so many newspapers to be bundled, and they were to be thrown out from the moving train. And where these newspapers were to be thrown out from the moving train on the Rameswaram road. And this Rameswaram road was between Rameswaram and Dhanushkodi. Between that passage, newspapers were to be thrown because there was a complete emergency. Okay. So this forced his cousin, Samusdin, who used to distribute newspaper in Rameswaram. Okay. And for that, he required help because now this job of newspaper distribution, it has become a challenge. It has become so difficult. So that's why already his cousin who was doing that job, Samusdin, he required help in that. And he was finding any person who could catch the bundles naturally, okay? And who was given that job? APJ Abdul Kalam. Now, what was his job? He filled the slot, he took that newspapers, okay? And Samusdin helped him to earn his first wages. It means, now APJ Abdul Kalam, he started earning money by distributing the newspaper, and this was his first wages, you can say, the money earned by doing any kind of work. So half a century later, what is the meaning of half a century later? What is the meaning of half a century? Tell me. Ninth class, get up. What is the meaning of half a century? Yes. 50 years. Even after 50 years, APJ Abdul Kalam is saying that he could feel the surge of pride. It means his pride that he had earned money in his childhood. That pride, that thing, it was raising in his, okay, clear? So it means he was feeling proud of himself that at a very small age, he could earn money. Now let's move to next paragraph, fourth paragraph. Okay, Simran, you read fourth paragraph. Yes, Imran. Simran, start reading.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, before starting the paragraph I'm supposed to read, ma'am, if I'm not wrong, you told us to write answers for the last two extra questions you gave from the chapter, The Snake and the Mirror. And you said after the weekend, when our next class will be, you'll be asking those. So we need to write it in our enough notebooks. So
you can do it in your notebook because we have spent so many days on that chapter and I have provided you a list of so many hints. Okay. So you can do it in your fair notebooks. Okay?
Yes, ma'am. Okay.
Start reading fourth.
Every child is born with some inherited characteristics into a specific socio-economic and emotional environment and trained in certain ways by figures of authority. I inherited honesty and self-discipline from my father, from my mother. I inherited faith in goodness and deep kindness. And so did my three brothers and sister. I had three close friends in my childhood, Ramanadha Shastri, Aravindan, and Siva Prakasam. All these boys were from orthodox Hindu Brahmin families. As children, none of us ever felt any difference among ourselves because of our religious differences and upbringing. In fact, Ramanadha Shastri was the son of Pakshi Lakshmana Shastri, the high priest of the Rameshwaram temple. Later, he took over the priesthood of the Rameshwaram temple from his father. Aravindan went into the business of arranging transport for visiting pilgrims, and Siva Prakasam became a catering contractor for the Southern Railways.
Now see, now you are going to read something very much interesting because this was all about his childhood. Okay? How did he earn money? How did he first earn his first wages? What were the circumstances at that time? Now you will come to know other personality trait of APJ Abdul Kalam, that he belonged to a Muslim family, but his friends, they all belong to a Orthodox Hindu family. See, in this paragraph, it is told by APJ Abdul Kalam that every child is born with some inherited characteristic. Inherited characteristic, it means those qualities that which we take from our parents, from our father and mother. Okay. And each child has those traits and into a specific socio-economical and emotional environment, that we all are brought up in a socio-economical and emotional environment. Every person has a different social environment. Every person has an economical different environment and emotional environment, and they are trained in the different kind of ways by figures of authorities. It means the nature of parents are different. It means your parents' nature, his parent or her parents' nature will be different. There are so many students who are right in front of me, but environment of every family will be different. So whatever he learned from his family members, he learned honesty. He learned self-discipline from his father, from his mother. He learned faith in goodness and to have a kindness. So he, all these traits were having inherited in his brothers and sisters also. During his childhood, he was having three friends. The names of three friends are given. And all these three friends, they belong to a Orthodox Hindu Brahmin families. Okay, but children, they never do any kind of discrimination on the basis of caste. Suppose in your class there can be some Sikhs, there can be some Hindus, but do you have any discrimination? Not at all. We never think like this. Even we are grown up, we also don't think like that. But this is the autobiography at that time. Okay, when Second World War was going on, near about in 1939. So these days are depicted that his friends, they belong to Hindu Brahmin families. Okay, but as a children, we were not having any differences among ourselves because during their upbringing, when they were brought up, at that time, parents have never did any kind of discrimination. This kind of teaching were not given to them. Okay, so it is given there that one of the friend, belonged to a priest family. Okay. Another friend, he went to the business of arranging transport for visiting pilgrims, and Siva Prakasan, he became a catering contractor for the Southern Railways. So these jobs were taken by them later on. So this was all about in first, second, third, and fourth paragraph. We will continue this paragraph tomorrow because we are running out of time, and I hope my student will go through this text again. By the time you complete your chapter, The Snake and the Mirror, at any time I can send you schedule to submit me your notebooks. But by the time you start completing it, okay? So students, take care of yourself. After this class, I think you have another class. After taking your class, please send me two names from Mahadevi Verma house and two names from another house that I think more from Kalidas house to those who wish to participate in report writing. Okay, and I require 8 students from that Pushpa Gujral Science City, that competition that I have sent you in WhatsApp, all the details. So you go through all the details and give me your names. Otherwise, I will take your names from my own site. I will not tell you. After selecting your names, I will let you know that your names are selected and given in the office. So don't give me a chance to give your name willingly with your wish. Okay, students, now thank you and have a nice day. Take care of yourself. Do study and do not put off till tomorrow what you can do today. Okay, students, thank you. Take care.